You know, we work all year, and there's a reason I work so hard, and Fairfax does, and our whole advisory board, it's because of this man right over here. Arnold Schwarzenegger, the governor, has been an inspiration to myself since I was a kid. In fact, the first time I met him, he threw me out of his movie trailer when you were doing Raw Deal in Chicago. Sven threw me out. You didn't throw me out. Arnold is truly a historical figure. And, I say this every year, but I really, there's nothing could be truer, because there are very few people born on the planet who have given back and done the things, and anything that this man goes after, he wins. He is the epitome of someone who can make anything happen. It doesn't matter what it is. He sets his mind to it as a bodybuilder, as a politician, as a businessman. There is nothing that this person couldn't do. And look what he's done with the Arnold Sports Festival. It is now on 6 continents around the world, the largest sports festival in the world. What he has done is beyond remarkable, and he just continues to amaze and inspire all of us. Those of us that know him for so many years, we still want our picture taken with every time. I mean, how many people, when I travel overseas, I got 1,000 Chinese lined up to get a picture with me, and they bring you a frame with you pictured in it later. So I have all these frames. I don't know what to do with them. I just put them in the back room. But Arnold is so different than really anyone I've met in my life. I mean, it really is, it's an honor every time you're with us, and we get to do things with you. And that's the reason this takes place here. And the reason we're going to do this every year at the Arnold Sports Festival, it is the place to be, because you're our hero, and we so much appreciate all the great work you're doing and the work that you continue to do. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you very much, Bob. This is not just one person's doing to do the Arnold Classic every year. If I wouldn't have Jim Lorimer as a partner for the last 41 years, this wouldn't have happened. And if I wouldn't have had friends like Bob Goldman that have been there from day one and they've helped, and if we wouldn't have had all the volunteers here in Columbus, we're talking about thousands of volunteers, none of this would have happened. So it's thank you very much for having your Hall of Fame Award ceremony every year here. We really appreciate having you. And what is so great is that you're really celebrating great people, people that have contributed so much to society, to the world. I mean, if you think about Lou Ferrigno, I mean, Lou Ferrigno, you know, this man here is not only a very talented man in so many different areas. But what I love about Lou Ferrigno is that he is a workhorse. That man never has shied away from working. No matter what it is, if it is on a movie set, or if it, I have seen him in the gym working out, or if it is training someone else, or having his mail order business, or taking care of his family, it doesn't matter what it is, he is never shy of working. He's never been lazy, and that's what I love about him. And I always tell bodybuilders around the world, I said, don't just think about your body. Think about going beyond that and all the things that you can accomplish and all the things that you can contribute to the world. And Lou is a perfect example of that. So let's give him a big hand for the great work that he's been doing. Really. And if it is Bill Kazmaier, who I have admired for many, many years, I always was dreaming about having the strength of Bill Kazmaier. It was always just a dream, but what the hell. But it was just great to see actually someone doing it for real and also having had such an impact and inspired so many people. And Dr. Tom Rosandich, I mean, thank you very much for all the great work that you have done. You're an extraordinary human being, and you always have promoted sports and fitness around the world. And you've done it your way, which was an extraordinary way. So thank you very much for the great contributions that you have made. Thank you. And Apollo Ono, thank you very much for, I still remember watching you winning those medals and doing your performance. I mean, I think in bodybuilding, we wish we have this kind of grace and this kind of moves that you guys have. I mean, but we don't. But I mean, that's what makes you great in what you do. So thank you very much and being such a great inspiration also. And Herschel Walker, I mean, what can I say about the guy that is that strong, that fit, that fast, that coordinated and everything. I mean, you were an outstanding athlete, one of the supreme athletes of all times. And so it's great to sit next to you here and to sit next to such a great, great man and such a great figure and someone that is also, again, so inspirational to so many people. And I think this is what this is all about. Is sports is about, after you've gone through your trip about being the best, we have the responsibility to go now and inspire others. Because everyone that is up here, I guarantee you, and as Lou Ferrigno already said, he was inspired by picking up a magazine and seeing this great physique on the magazine. I was inspired by having Reg Park on the cover of a magazine, and I saw this magazine in a store, and I picked it up, and I read through it, and I said, that's the kind of life that I want to have, and be a champion, and all of those things. So I think we have the responsibility to go out and inspire others. That's what it's all about, because in the end, remember, we are not going to be judged by how much we make, but by how much we give. So it's always about not me, but we. Thank you very much. Thank you all.